Hey, this is Josh Howard calling in to speak to Jazzi Black.
What up, Big Josh?
2003 first-round draft pick. You were named to the 2007 All-Star team. And you'd have been to the playoff multiple times. And you were part of the 2016 that took us to the finals. I know it feels good to see the Mavericks in this position again.
It's great, man. Like you say, to see, you know, what happened back in the day and kind of see the similarities from this season. You know, we just got to finish this series out. I know it's a tough one against Oklahoma, but I think we can get it done.
Yeah. Them young boys out there balling, ain't they?
Yes, they are. That's that youth.
Nah, for real, man. Game 4 on Monday night was crazy. We got down to the last 2 minutes and ultimately fell short 100-96. What do you think we could have done better? Because I was confused, Josh. I ain't gonna lie.
Well, from a basketball standpoint, you know, being a former player, I just think we just need to finish the game out, you know. Making free throws. I think that was the biggest thing.
Right.
That stood out, and just finishing the game as far as, you know, the possession on defense, stopping them and holding them to one shot.
Yeah. On top of all the pressure, you know, inside of the arena. And it's Mental Health Awareness Month, so we got to talk about, you know, how athletes can protect their peace but also stay focused on the game.
Well, I think, you know, sometimes really focusing on your task at hand, which is, you know, playing the best basketball you can play.
Right.
Shutting out all outside distractions the best way you can.
Right.
And really just focus in on you and your team and doing, you know, whatever the coach wants you to do to win that game.
Yeah, you got to lock in on that tunnel vision. And I just want to say you've been doing a wonderful job over at UNT Dallas, coaching the Trailblazers. How's it feel being Coach Howard?
Yeah, it's been a blessing. The transition has been good. This will be my 9th year, believe it or not, so I'm just amazed to be doing this long. And I mean, like, when anybody asks me that, I think the biggest joy I get from it is allowing these young men and women to use my platform to, you know, succeed in their career. So
That's
the best part about it.
That's cool. Was that always, like, ultimately your goal was to go back and coach?
No.
Oh, really? But look at you now, almost a decade in the game. God has a funny way of putting you where you need to be. You do a lot in the community, too. Talk to me about some of your community involvement.
One of the biggest things my foundation does is we reach back out to underserved communities and partner with the government to do feeding programs.
Oh, wow.
And, you know, it's just, you know, giving, you know, young men and women and adults an opportunity to, you know, to eat, you know, and it's just plain and simple. You know, a lot of these kids wake up in the morning and they might not have nothing going to school or to camp. And, you know, for us to offer that, it definitely gives an opportunity, you know, to not worry about where the next meal is coming from and kind of focus on other things that might can prepare their, you know, life.
Right.
So that's the major thing I've been doing over the past 10 years. And then I still do my camps back in my hometown and, of course, with my university where I've been coaching at, just partnering with them to do camps in the city. So just keeping it basic and just having fun with what I do.
First of all, nothing about that is basic, okay? So
yes.
Let me give you your flowers. Nothing about that is basic, and that's phenomenal. Please continue to keep doing that work, because people also need to see that image, too. Far as just, like, being back and, you know, being a community leader, or a real stand-up community leader. So that's what's up.
Yeah, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Look, tonight, I know it'd be a lot going on. I got a chance to chop it up with, like, Chris Arnold, who's, like, the MC, Big Rob, who's one of the Mavs Maniacs. And I know you know all about the entertainment and the hype inside of the arena.
They do an excellent job keeping the guys, the crowd entertained.
Yeah.
And I just think that's one thing that, you know, us as players, we fed off of was the energy that our fans gave us. And that's why, you know, when people ask me about, you know, what I like the best, and it definitely was, you know, the fan support and how they pushed us to play better.
Yeah.
So I think that plays a big part in, you know, us being successful. When I mean us, I mean the Mavs. So just keep supporting them.
Because
I know that it goes a long way with it.
Nah, for real. And we could see it. We could tell. I'm like, you know, crowds start getting, everybody get up. Get up.
Yeah, please. Yes, get up.
Well, you need it, especially in the playoffs. And what do you think was your best playoff performance?
Oh, man. That's a great question, because I've had a lot of successful playoff runs with the Mavs. So,
yeah.
I guess the one I would have to say is just when we got over the hump and beat San Antonio to make it to that Western Conference Finals and win. And then go on ahead to the, you know, NBA championship. Unfortunately, like you said, we lost in 06, but the experience in itself is one of a kind.
Yeah.
And to have that is definitely hats off.
You know, just with your time in the league, the Mavericks have gone through so many different transitions, you know, different slogans, new year, new team, new energy. And right now their slogan is One for Dallas. What does that mean to you?
I mean, I just think it's a play on the word Dallas and the word all as well. It's us sticking together and being together as one unit. And again, like you say, kind of like that fan base just pushing the Mavs, you know, forward. And hopefully we can get to that position again where we can win a championship. So I think that slogan is big, and I think it echoes a lot of, you know, people really pay attention to it.
I know, that's right. One for Dallas. You know, one thing we're going to do is ride for each other. Now, look, I'm going to put you on the spot and put that pressure on you. Do you have a favorite player right now?
Definitely going to go with Luka. I just enjoy the pace that he plays at and how people can't speed him up. So that's just a gift in itself to watch.
Yeah.
I'm still a fan of watching Kevin Durant play. I just think he's just a natural-born scorer. And he deals with a lot of off-the-court stuff and still shows up to work a lot as far as dealing with people heckling them.
Right.
So I think I like the fact that he pushes through that. And then Anthony Edwards.
Mm.
Yeah, I love watching him play as well. So those would be like my top three I enjoy watching play.
That's what's up, man. Well, you know, congratulations again on everything. But it's lit. Game 5 is going down tonight in OKC. Josh, I think you should do the shout-out to tell everybody to tune in.
Hey, it's your boy Josh Howard signing in right now, and I encourage everybody to support the Mavs tonight and check them out on TV at 8:30 against the Oklahoma City Thunder. We definitely need this win, so when they come back on Saturday, the American Airlines Arena will be rocking, and hopefully we can finish it out. But we need to win this game first, so let's go Mavs.